Using schematic manuals, we can determine what working voltage we need in each line and in each component. During this course, I'll try to teach you most of the tricks we have used over the last few years. A good diagnosis consists of taking small steps and, at the end of it, draw our conclusion. The third step to perform an electronic circuit analysis is to measure the reference of the diodes, also known as impedance measurement. Impedance measurement is usually used to determine the amount of resistance present in any electrical circuit. To measure the impedance, so to speak, we place the tester in diode mode and with the red tip to ground, and with the black tip we measure the component. In this way, we can measure test points such as these gold circles, most of the SMD components and FPC connectors, such as the screen connector, the charging connector, the camera connector, among others. In electronics, it's not the most right way to use the word measure impedance, but many people use it, so we'll do it as well. Through AliExpress, we can find these FPC connectors with the values noted, which makes our work much easier when we are repairing Apple devices. However, if you don't want to invest money in this flex, there are tools that help us to know all these values, such as ZXW. These connectors are very useful since they allow us to have all the voltages, impedance and name of each line in a clear and precise way. This will save us a lot of time when we are measuring. If your volume of work is not too high, there is no need to invest money in these tools. The Apple devices have connectors for all peripherals. Throughout our course, it's very important to understand how to measure the impedance on the motherboard so you can repair 90% of the devices. With a little effort, you'll be able to understand all the steps necessary to perform this task. It's nothing out of this world. Once you have mastered all these steps, you'll be able to understand the failures in the memory and the CPU. The fourth step for the measurement protocol is to measure the current in milliamperes or microamperes. To measure the current on the electronic motherboard, you'll need a multimeter. To use a multimeter to measure the current, first you must adjust the tester to the current scale. At the same time, we place the test cables in the corresponding place. To measure direct current, the multimeter is used as an ammeter and the unit of direct current is selected. Once the cables are connected, the multimeter will show the current flowing through the circuit. The unit of measurement of current intensity is the ampere and is measured in series. The current function on the motherboard of the electronic device is to determine the behavior of the electronic current flowing between the components of the motherboard. This information is used as part of the diagnosis of the mobile devices to detect problems such as a current leakage and short circuit, among others. There are special tools designed to measure current on electronic motherboards, such as multimeters, USB testers, or the Power Z, which can provide accurate and detailed information on current behavior. This allows the technician to detect failure in the devices and solve them efficiently. The Power Z tool is a useful USB device for measuring the consumption data of a device through a graph that is divided into voltage, current, and watt data. Basically, the Power Z tools help us to diagnose charging and consumption problems. This tool is ideal to performing consumption analysis of devices, such as verifying if a device is charging correctly or checking the consumption of the source we are using. The PowerZ tool has specialized software that allows different consumption analyses to be performed. The software includes timeline graphs of the consumption data as well as detailed reports showing consumption over time. The software also allows the tool to be correctly calibrated to ensure that the data is accurate.